In this video, I just want to make it clear real quick that I'm only talking about this card right here and the white version when flashing and overclocking specifically. I mean, it might work with other 4070 Ti Super brands, but I don't, you know, I only have experience with this card in particular. All right. The first thing I did with mine was flash it because the power is limited and they're all limited, but so I flashed it to this one, which works fine. So if you want to flash it to this one, go right ahead. It, from that one I just showed you to this one works great. Then I was like, you know what? Let's try to flash it to this one. Do not do that. Do not flash it to this one. It won't work. And then you have to flash it back. But if you flash it to this one, it does work. I know, right? That doesn't make any sense, but here we are. The power limit on it is 366 compared to what? 315. So, I mean, huge gains here. So, this is safe to do, but since this version of this card right here has two HDMIs and two displays or three display ports, you're going to lose one of your display ports because it's going to think it's a HDMI if you have this version of this card. I'm only talking to people that own the Zotac Trinity Black or White. I can't tell you about any other card, but I know this one right here. So if you get this stock version right here and it's the cheapest version you can get, you can flash it to this and you saved you a couple, like $100. And since you got this power level right here, you can match a 4080. So save you some even more money. So just to prove my point here, here is a Firestrike score, which I know it's not using ray tracing cores, but still, look at this. Here's my 4070 Ti Super, down here at the bottom. You see 44,437. The average of the 4080 here is 43,483. I crushed it. I mean, and this is all because it's using the same die, and I flashed it and overclocked it well, and boom, there you go. All right, now I'm on 4080 Supers here, okay? Look at my score compared to the average 4080 Super score. That's ridiculous. That's quite impressive, to be honest. So there's just another reason. I ain't bragging, there it is. Here's the 4070 Ti Super, 44,437. Here's the page I'm on. Remember, this is all with a 5900X, but I mean. And here's the prices of a 4080 Super. The prices of my card that outbeats a 4080 and a 4080 Super at Firestrike. Again, I know it's not using the ray tracing cores, but still. So there you guys go. I hope I helped. If anybody out there thinking about it or wanting to save money or wanting to flash. And again, I'm talking about this card in particular. I'm not talking about any other one. But what I've said here today might work with other cards. I don't know. But thanks for watching. Crash Project out. Peace.